Okay, so I'm starting here in Story View. I'm going to open up my slide here. This is just a content library quiz template slide, and I change the font here just to minimize the distraction because we're focusing on changing icons. Now, the icons I added were from content library, and the only thing I've done to get us started here was, if you look in the states panel, I added a custom state called correct. So we want to change the icon to green if the learner answers the question correctly. Now, real quick, just a side note on color. If you are using color to provide feedback, you probably want to include an icon or text because color alone is not a great way to provide feedback from an accessibility standpoint. So I just mentioned that, but it's just a demo. So I thought I would take just an easy way to, a quick way to show that distinction, but keep that in mind. All right, so the first thing I want to do is I've got these icons on the slide level. I don't want to have to manage everything at the slide level because I may want 20, 30 questions later on. The more I can put this on the slide master, the better. So I'm going to select all three icons. I'm going to cut them. Control X is my shortcut key right there. Go to the View tab and then the slide master. Now you have a couple options for working in the slide master. If we were doing, say, a regular progress meter where we just want to show progress across the entire course, you may want to put those icons on your topmost parent layout. Why? Well, let's try that and see. Notice when I paste them on the parent layout, they cascade down to each layout below. And I can't select them here because they're being managed by the parent. So that's how you would show icons and progress throughout the entire course. I don't want to do that here because we're only showing progress through a quiz, through a specific quiz slide. So I'm going to copy those or cut those again, cut them. And if I paste them on only the quiz layout slide, then I'll have that option for seeing them just here, but not on any other slide. Okay, I'm gonna return to my slide view. And I wanna begin now by creating the variables because we're gonna track how the learner does, how they perform over multiple slides. We're gonna need variables. So over here in the triggers panel, we have the variables icon for project variables. Go ahead and click that and pop open your variables. I'm going to add my first variable right here for question one. So we could just call that Q1. That makes sense. And in this case, it's true or false. That's the simplest. We could use text and numbers if we were managing multiple states for that trophy icon. But in this case, we just want to know if the learner answered the question correctly or incorrectly. Is it true? Is it false? Well, it's false by default. So that's what we'll keep as our starting value. So click OK. And then we'll go ahead and just create two more for additional questions. Now, well, I copied it. I guess I could paste it here. I don't have those slides created yet, but we'll create those in just a moment. Q2, and then we'll paste one more for question three. So three variables, three questions, but we don't really have those. We only have one slide so far. All right, click OK, and they're all true, false. Yes, they are. That's great. So there's multiple ways that we can manage how we adjust that variable, but probably the simplest way is just to work with the built-in feedback layers that Storyline has created for us. We're just working with the regular quiz slide, but if you look down here in the slide layers, we have a congrats or a correct layer and an incorrect layer. Well, we could add the trigger to the congrats layer because the learner's only gonna see this layer if they answer the question correctly. And we don't need to really add one on the sorry layer because it's already false by default. So on the congrats layer or the correct layer, add a new trigger. And the question we're gonna ask ourselves is what? What is it we wanna do? We wanna change the variable for question one, right? So that's called the adjust variable. And there it is. Change it from Q1 to a value, set Q1 to a value of true when the timeline starts on this layer. So this layer is only going to be shown if the user answers the question correctly, and the variable will only be changed to true if the learner answers the question correctly. So click OK. That's great. Now what we can do is we can duplicate the slide for the remainder of the questions. What I like about this approach, so we'll just duplicate it, is that if we wanted to add more icons, say maybe four questions, five questions, we could make that change in the slide master and all of these slides will update automatically. So congrats layer, you can see right now we already have the trigger set, but we do need to change that from Q1 to Q2, right? That's the second variable for the second question. And then we'll duplicate this one more time. And again, on the congrats layer, just change the Q2 this time for to Q3. Okay, so we have our slides set up. The variable changes when the learner hits the congrats layer. Now we're gonna jump back into the slide master so we can add the triggers on the slide master that'll carry through all of these question slides. View slide master, and we're on the slide with the icons. Now we just need to change the state of each icon based on the value of the variable. So new trigger, and what is it we wanna do? We wanna change the state of, and we'll just go right in order. So trophy Q1, we'll change it to correct. When the timeline starts on, we could start on the object because the object timeline starts at the beginning, but just as a general best practice, I'll just set it to slide, when the slide timeline begins. Okay, now finally, we need a condition. We don't wanna just change that to correct every time the slide loads, because what if they answer incorrectly? So that's where the condition is so important. So the condition is only if that Q1 variable, if that Q1 variable is equal to true. If it equals true, go ahead and change it. If it doesn't, forget about it, okay? Now, we have the first trigger set up. I'm gonna group these. It'll keep them a little bit closer in order. With that, I'm gonna select it, copy that trigger, and then we can click the little clipboard icon right here to paste it, and now we can just make those updates. So we're gonna say change the state of trophy 2 to correct if Q2 equals true. And then we copy this one, paste it, and then we'll just change finally to trophy 3 if the Q3 is equal to true. Okay, close out of the master view. Let's preview the project and see how it looks. All right, so they're all gray by default. This first choice is the correct choice. I click submit, go to the next slide, and there's my trophy. Click the next one, and there it is changing, and then if we miss this one, so on, but we don't have a slide to go to. And that's how easy it is. Now, one thing you might notice, let me reset this. I'm gonna close it out again, try it again. If, let's just say, for example, you wanted the icons to change immediately at the slide level. Notice how I click the first one, and I click submit, and we're on the slide layer for the submit feedback. It's not changing. Why? Because it's not adjusting, if the variables change, but we're not changing the state of this until the timeline begins, which is the next time we go to the next, which is the next time we go to the next slide. So if you wanted that to be instantaneous, you just have to add another series of triggers. So let's go into the slide master. So view slide master, and what we'll do this time is make the event when the variable changes. So we have these initial triggers that are adjusting or changing the object states based on the variable when the timeline starts, but we also could say change the state of, we'll go through it again, it's gonna be almost the same, to correct, not when the timeline starts, but when the variable, not when the dial turns, I don't know what happened right there. Where's my variable changes? There's my variable changes, when the variable changes of Q1, if Q1 is equal to correct. So the difference here is that this will change it at the current slide level, but we really need, you need, this is an option. This is more of an aesthetic design option, which I really would use, but you would want this one, the first one we did, has to be there, because as you move from slide to slide, you need to be able to track those progress. This is only, what we're doing here is only gonna take effect, right? This is the variable trigger, only affects it on the current slide. You need this series of triggers to make it persistent across multiple slides. So I'm gonna select this one, copy, paste. We'll say the same thing again, right? Trophy Q2, if Q2 is equal to true, and paste it, and we'll say trophy Q3. So I'll show you now how this works. And we have those really the same trigger, but just in a different event. So close out of master view, preview. Okay, so we select our choice, make our submit. It changes here, but watch what happens when we go to the next slide. It disappears. So we need both of those if we wanna show the change on the current slide as well as future slides. So that's why we want both, that's why we have both. Go back to view, slide master one more time, and let's just enable all of those triggers. Now we have everything here on the slide, and really that's how you can set up your progress meter. I did mention earlier that if you wanted to add additional questions, just select your icons. You can obviously position them a little bit more, and we'll just duplicate this last trophy icon. Just click and drag to make a copy of it, and we'll call that one Trophy Q4. Right? And so then we can add another variable. Just call that one Q4, and so on. So we just need to keep adding additional variables and duplicate those icons. And what's nice is then you'll just make another trigger right for each one of these, and you can continue adding or removing them. Let's say you only wanted two. You could delete those two, and the rest of these triggers can remain because it doesn't matter. They're just not going to apply because it's not being changed. So that's how easy it is to really expand or contract or modify how many questions you have in your series of quizzes. And that's really all you need to know. If you have any questions, as always, you can hit me up and I'll be more than happy to help. Thanks.